Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In previous video tutorial, we have seen how to integrate Spring Boot with Google Guava Cache. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about the Caffeine Cache. Basically, we'll see how to integrate Spring Boot with Caffeine Cache. If you go to the Spring Boot official website documentation, then if you come down, then they have listed all caching which is supported by the Spring Boot. And when you start the application, then in a startup itself, Spring Boot is gonna scan what kind of dependency related to caching is added in the class path. So, and that will check and this is the priority list. So we are going to last time we had added Guava, now we are going to add Caffeine. So based on the priority order, Caffeine will be used by the Spring Boot. So as I said, Caffeine is the latest that is the enhanced version of Guava, Google Guava Cache itself. So if you go to the documentation, they have given description. Caffeine is a Java 8 rewrite of Guava's cache and will supersede the Guava support in Spring Boot 2.0. so here if you go to the Spring Boot initializer page, then we are using latest stable version is 1.5.6, but 2 is in milestone version, so that is not released yet. So before that 1.5.7 is going to release. So anyway, we are using the latest stable version, and so from 2 onwards, Spring Boot 2 onwards, they are going to use Caffeine, right? Now if Caffeine is present in the class path, then Caffeine Cache Manager will be automatically configured in a Spring Boot application, right? And caches can be created on the startup using this attribute. So this is the common attribute which basically we use across many caching, as we had used in the Guava cache as well, right? So to specify the cache name, and you can customize this caching by specifying this kind of properties, or you can register some your own bin, right? So these are the two property I'm going to specify to implement Caffeine. On the top of that, if you want to define some kind of class loader, then also you can define, but this is not really needed. So now here we have we are going to create a project to implement Caffeine cache with Spring Boot. So I'm going to copy my previous project which we had created for the Guava cache, and I'll paste with this name Spring Boot. Instead of Guava, you will apply it Caffeine cache. Sorry, it's Caffeine. And first of all, you need to add the Caffeine dependency in your class path, right? So what I'll go to Google and I'll search for the Caffeine Maven dependency, and this will give you the link. So latest version is 2.1.0, I think, but you don't need to worry about that. So when you work with the Spring Boot, then you don't care about the version and all. This all those stuff is taken care of by the Spring Boot itself. Now here, if you go to here, then we in earlier video tutorial we had added dependency for the Guava, so that I'm gonna replace it over here with Caffeine. And here you don't need to really specify the version. If you press Control and you click over here, then you can see now you can see Caffeine version is already taken care by the Spring Boot itself. And if you go to the top, then they would have defined this version as well. Now you can see they have defined latest version is 2.3.5, so that is going to use by the Spring Boot itself. So we have added Caffeine related dependency in our class path. And if you look in the pom.xml, so rest of the things already I had explained in previous video tutorial. we are using a Spring Data JPA, we are going to expose some RESTful API so that we can test our caching concept. We have added dependency for the caching, and we have added dependency for caffeine just now. We have added actuator dependency for MySQL and to write the test, generate test cases, and finally one plugin which helps us to generate the executable jar. Now you can see there is some error because we earlier we had defined a cache manager for our Guava cache, right? So that I'm gonna delete it. So if you want to explicitly define cache manager for caffeine as well, that you can define as we did in the Guava, Spring Boot Guava integration, right? So now you can go to the properties file, and here you need to specify some property. So there are some property which is related to the Guava cache that you will have to replace. So here cache type, this is not really needed, but still you can specify these things. Now if you go to the documentation website, then they have given some description, so you can specify these things. That is very much similar to the Guava itself, but properties name got changed. Now for caffeine, it's caffeine. For Guava, you can have a Guava. And now here I'm going to specify 600 maximum size and expired after access, so let's say 700, and that's it. And now you are ready to use caffeine. Now if I run my application, before that what I'll do, I'll try to search caffeine cache configuration, which is available in the auto configuration jar. So in Spring Boot application, we have a Spring Boot auto configure, and you have a different classes for the different caching. You can see for Guava as well, but that is saying I have deprecated in this version. So if you go to the caffeine cache configuration, and here you can see you don't here you can see you don't really need to define the cache loader, so that is already taken care by this. And here I'm going to put a debug point, and let's see how this works, right? So I went inside the dot class file, and I have given the debug point. So here caffeine cache manager is created automatically. Still you want to create your own caching manager, then you can create a configuration file, and there you can define a bean, right? And this is a private method. This too is private method, which is going to access by this guy, right? So now everything is configured for caffeine caching, and this project I'm gonna close. Now caffeine cache, everything is on place. Now where I made changes, sorry guys, I made change in the wrong project. So I was supposed to make changes in this, so here we'll have to change it again. I made changes in the project which is for the Guava. So I let's say this is 600 and this is 700, right? And cache type, we will have to specify caffeine. By mistake, I had made changes in the project which is for the Guava. I was supposed to make changes over here. Now let's say dependency where I had added. Okay, dependency also I have added in the wrong place. So I made changes over here, sorry guys. I was supposed to change in the newly created project. So here caffeine related dependency also we have to add over here. So let's add. So this we have to replace with the caffeine. So this increases the rework, right? So let me close it. And now everything here, this also we will have to remove it. Now we are almost done. Now let's debug this, run this application in debug mode, and we had given some breakpoint, right? So let me check it again. Caffeine cache configuration, and here we had given some breakpoint. Now let's debug as a Spring Boot app or Java application, you can say. Now click on OK. Actually this caching basically works on the proxy object, and that's what we were getting those kind of messages. Now press F6. Now press F8. Click on OK. Now you can see Caffeine cache manager is getting created, and you can see cache name what we had given in the property file, that is coming over here, right? And if you press F6, now you can see now we had given the cache name, and from that cache name caffeine cache is getting created. Press F5. Now you can see cache is getting created. Now you can see rest of the flows goes on. So I'm going to press F8. I'm going to cancel all this stuff, and now let's disable this cache, this debug point. Now our application is up and running. Now I'm going to test one API and make sure that this cache is working properly. So what I have done, I have written all URL of API. So now here, if you look into the, we have a controller, and in the controller we have exposed some RESTful API. So I have opened a lot of files. So if you go to the controller, then we have a rest of the lot of API, right? To get ticket information from the database, deleting record from the database, and updating ticket information database. We have us, and from here we are making call to the service layer. And service layer, we are making use of the cache. So when we get ticket information from the database, then after getting the information from the database, ticket information, we are caching with this key. If database returns null, then we are not going to cache it. Similarly, if we delete some records from the database, then we are evicted that record with that key from the cache. And if we are updating some records on the database, then we are updating our cache as well with this key, right? So let's test it whether our cache is working or not. So here I'm going to access my database. So I have a record with 2 in my database. If I press, then I got the information with this key, this with this primary key. And you can see there would be a select query is triggered for this by JPA, right? A Spring Data JPA. But if I ask for the same record again, then this is database, is this method execution of our service method is not gonna happen, and this information will be returned to the cache itself. That's the magic of cache, right? You can see there is no select query is fired, right? Because first time when we retrieve ticket information with ID 2, then that is already kept into the cache with this key, and same is getting returned from the next accession onwards. Similarly, if you delete some records from the cache, then we'll remove that entry from the cache. So this API you can test yourself. API I have listed, URI I have listed over here. So once you download this code from the GitHub, then you will have to set up the database. And here we have a DB script that will insert few records into your database, and this will create a database table in your application. Thing is that only you will have to allow here, you will have to make it true. So this will create the table and insert the database as well. So I hope you enjoyed learning this video. This code you'll get on the GitHub, and GitHub location you'll get in the video description. Thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.